Topic name is money market. First, what is money market? Money market is a market for dealing with financial assets and securities which have a maturity period of up to 1 year. In other words, it is a market for purely short-term funds. Basically, this is the market for short funds. The basic time period is 1 year. A market for dealing in monetary assets for short-term nature, less than 1 year, which enable raising up of short-term funds for meeting temporary shortage of fund and obligation and temporary deployment of excess time. They just need the money just maybe less than 1 year and or 1 year. Means if they take a if they borrow money from the financial institution, they just take it only for the 1 year or less than 1 year. So basically, the major participant of the money market is the RBI and the commercial banks. So RBI and commercial provides the finance to the clients. There are some features of money market. It is market purely for short term funds or financial assets for near money. Basically, with the help of money market, we can easily generate a shorter. We can easily arrange the money for a short term. For example, if I need money and maybe after 1 year, I need to return the money where we have to borrow. It deals with the financial assets have a maturity period up to 1 year only. But in the capital market, the maturity period is more than 1 year. But in a money market, the maturity period is 1 year. Means you need to return money within a specific time period only. It deals with only those assets which can be converted into cash readily without loss or with minimum transaction cost. In the money market, we can deal with those assets. For example, if we have a gold loan, we can easily sell and we can easily that asset convert into money without any loss and with minimum transaction cost. Generally, transactions take place through phone. How can we do transactions? We can also do via phone, via oral communication, and relevant documents, written communication can be exchanged subsequently. Means we can generally in the money market we need to do transaction with the help of phone or oral communication. But while we do any transactions, but we need a relevant documents and written communication can be exchanged subsequently. So there is no formal place like stock exchange in the case of capital market. Transactions have to conduct without the help of the brokers. Means without the help of any kind of broker, we can easily do the transactions in the money market. The components of a money market are the central bank. Who are the components of money market? Central bank, commercial banks, non-banking financial companies, discount houses, acceptance house. Commercial banks generally play a most important role in this market. So these are the organizations which are the component of which are the element of the money market. Now that we discuss objectives of money market, the major objectives are equilibrium mechanism for evening out short-term surplus and deficiency. They have to manage the each and every transaction in the organization. Focal point for influencing liquidity economy. The main motive they want liquidity in the economy. Access to use of short-term funds at a reasonable cost. Means it is each and every customer can easily use the funds for a short-term and at a reasonable cost. Means we do not need to pay high tax to the authorities, to the financial institution. Means with the minimum cost, with the minimum interest, they can use the short-term funds. The other objectives, to provide a parking place to employ short-term surplus funds, to provide room for overcoming short-term deficits, to enable the central bank to influence and regulate liquidity in the economy through its intervention in the market. Means there are many organizations who first research about the market, what is currently running the market, and first they analyze it, then they invest money, and in this way they can easily improve the economy of the nation. To provide a reasonable access to the user of short term to meet the requirements quickly, adequately, and reasonable cost. Means the main motive of money market is money market can easily fulfill the requirements of those people who need funds, and with a reasonable price, and set up their business, or we may be invest in the market to expand the business. There are some types of money market: call money market, commercial bill market, trade bills market, commercial paper market, certificate of deposit markets, repo market, key purchase agreement, and banker acceptance. These are the some types which comes under the money market. Now I will discuss one by one in the coming slides. These are the components which I explained in the previous slides. Now, first, what is call market? Basically, in this market, the loans are repaid or repayable on demand at the option of either the lender or the borrower. Means we take a loan. If we take a borrow from a financial institution, if we have to recover, if the borrower's requirement, then immediately we pay the loan on the demand of the higher authority. Another option is the lender or the borrower. Means if you borrow money from a friend, if they want money, then it is your duty, you have to repay the money to the borrower person, to the lender person who gave you. The special feature of this market is that the interest rate varies from day to day and even hour to hour at the center to center. In that case, if you take a loan from the in the call, the interest rate varies from day to day. Maybe your interest will be very low today. In the next year, the interest rates will be very high, even hour to hour and center to center. It depends upon the organizations, those who take loan from this type of money market. So it is very sensitive to changes in demand and supply for all loans. Those who take all loans, so there means there we can see the numerous changes, numerous demand. There is more supply. Some people give, some people borrow. So if the interest is very high, definitely those people will generate a higher profit. And those take loan, they need to pay the more amount. So in India, call money markets are associated with the presence of stock exchanges, and hence they are located in major industrial towns. I mean, these kind of markets are situated in the major industrial towns like Bombay, Calcutta, Madras, Delhi, and Ahmedabad. And basically, they have to deal with only stock exchange. They exchange the stock. So that's why they take loan. Now, the commercial bills market. The commercial bill is a short term negotiating and self liquidating instrument with low risk. Means if you do any kind of dealing with the help of commercial bill market, means basically it is a short term, and the two parties contract with each other, and in that case we have a low risk. Dealing with commercial bills or bills of exchange or trade bills means when we export or something, then we can use this kind of bills in the organization. The commercial bills are issued by the seller on the buyer, drawing for the value of goods delivered by him. Basically, this bill is issued by the seller, means those persons who sell the goods to the another one, to the buyer, for the value of goods delivered by him, whatever he delivered to the buyer. And the bills are maturity period is 30 days, 60 days, 90 days. Means again, within 3 months, you have to pay the amount which the goods you have to consume, which goods you have to use. Next, the trade bill market. The trade bills, also known as T-bills, are short-term money market instrument issued by the central bank on the behalf of government. basically this kind of bill issued by the central bank on the behalf of government to curb temporary liquid shortfalls. Means they want to curb means when we have to congested something and when we have to want to decline something. Means we don't want our values of this will be declined. To curb temporary liquid shortfall, these do not yield any interest and but issued at a discount. With this kind of bills, in this type of way, we can easily get a means the authority will give a discount to the client at its redemption price and then wrap it as per when it gets mature. So I think you can see this is the kind of prey bill. The picture is visible to you. It is a market for trade bills which has short-term maturity. Again, this type of market also has short-term maturity. And it is a promissory note or a finance bill issued by the government. It is highly liquid because its repayment is guaranteed by the government. So in that kind of bill means you never come in the loss position. It is guaranteed. The authority will receive an amount. Means the government take the full guarantee of this kind of bills. It is an important instrument for short-term borrowing of the government. So it is a really important instrument for the government can borrow money for the short term. There are three types of bills: 91-day bills, 182 days T bills, and 364 days T bills. It depends on which one. Whether you want to take 91, 182, and 364. It's like a maturity period, which you need to repay your amount within these time period. Next, second type is short-term loan market. It's a market where short-term loans are given to the corporate customers for meeting their working capital requirements. Means, in that case, we will provide the loans to the corporate customers, those who will fulfill the requirements if they need money. Because if they need money to complete the task in the organization. Commercial banks play a significant role in this market, which is really important, and this is the main component in the market. This bank provides short-term loans in the form of cash credit and overdraft. Means this bank provides short-term loans, means we can also take money and you can also take an overdraft. Overdraft facilities are mainly given to the business people, whereas cash credit is given to industrialists. Because basically, overdraft facility given to those people who are already working in who have their own business, whereas cash credit is given to the those industries which are very big in a particular regional state. Overdraft is purely a temporary accommodation, and it is given in the current account itself. Because it is a temporary accommodation which they provide to the businessman, and it is in the current account itself. If you have current account, then you can avail this kind of facility. But cash credit is for a period of 1 year, and it is sanctioned separate account. If you take a cash credit from the organization, the period of this 1 year, and basically for cash credit, it is separate accounts. Then you can avail this facility. If you have a separate account, then you can take the benefit of this facility. The next is commercial paper market. The scheme of commercial paper market was introduced in 1990 for a short-term financing issue. They can be issued in multiple of rupees 5 lakhs and in multiple thereof. One time they can issue the 5 lakh rupees to the client. As per RBI guidelines, the commercial paper can be issued on the following conditions. I mean, there are two conditions. On the basis of these conditions, they are giving the amount to their client. The minimum tangible net worth of company is to be at least rupees 4 crore. Means net worth of every company's minimum is 4 crore. If they have net worth is in the 4 crore, then they can take this facility. The working capital limit should have been sanctioned by the bank or financial institutions. Means the working capital limit facility should be, means it is mandatory, if sanctioned by the bank or financial institutions. Means you have the working capital in the organization. If you don't have working capital limit, then you are unable to take this facility. Commercial paper is defined as a short-term unsecured money market instrument issued as a promissory note by the big corporations have excellent credit ratings. Those who have good credit ratings, then these kind of people, the big corporation can use this facility. As it is a freely instrument and high freely transfer instrument and has liquidity, and we can easily free transfer amount, and the liquidity is very high. As the instrument is not backed by collateral, only large firms with considerable financial strength are authorized to issue the instrument. Only big organizations have a good financial strength, and they can and are authorized, means they are the legally company. They have good strength. They have good finance. Then they can use this kind of facility. Even the government also issue this facility to the big organization. Certificate of deposit market. It is a time deposit with a bank. A money market instrument which is negotiated and equivalent to a promissory note. Basically, it is directly contact with the bank, and in this case, we have to negotiate, and we should also take a promissory note, and we do a contract between two parties. CD have a specific maturity date is from 3 months to 5 years. 3 months to 5 years. A stated interest rate and can be issued any denominations, much like bonds. Means the interest rate is stated, means they have mentioned what for it. It is decided by the authority what interest you have to pay if you take a loan through with this type of category. And in that case, basically, we are investing in terms of bonds. Most CDS has a penalty for early withdrawal prior to the CDS date of maturity. If we early withdraw our amount, and this category of people avail a penalty from their clients prior to the date of maturity. Means when we have to time frame will be completed, then we need to withdraw our money which we have to deposit in a with a bank. Because if we have to basically first we get deposit with the bank, means particular amount which we have deposited in a bank, then we will return document the sign I have to deposit this amount. We also make a proof from the authority. Then we when we if we deposit one amount, if do a contract for a 1 year, one year I want to save our money in a particular organization, the particular bank, then it is a duty of authority, they have to pay interest of 1 year. And if we withdraw amount before 1 year, then we need to pay a penalty to the bank organization. Because before maturity period, we cannot withdraw our amount in a particular bank organization. Next is repo rate. A repurchase repo agreement involves a sale of security with an agreement to purchase the same security bank at a higher price at a later date. Means this is a type of agreement. First, whatever securities we have to sell the security to the client. Again, we buy that we buy that security. Then again, we have to sell this security at a higher price, maybe in a future time. A repurchase agreement or repo sale of securities for a cash with a commitment of repurchase done at a specified price at a future date. For example, if you buy a gold, as you know now the today price is 50,000. The value of gold is depend on the 10 gram is 50,000. Now it is your security money you have. If you sell your gold, maybe 1 year, means the price will be varying. Maybe you will get the price of that gold is maybe 60,000 and 70,000. Means whatever security you have in the coming period, your secure what goods you have, the value of your security will be increased. So in this way, if you once you have to buy something or sell something and again you purchase it, then again sell it, the value of the secure of the goods will be increased in the future time. For example, the another example I will give you, if I talk about the in about 2000, the gold price is around 10,000. If you have gold on that time, now you compare the value of 2000-2021. Means after 10 decades, the price of the gold is 50,000. Means if you have, it means now you have to sell, you will get 40,000 profit from that such security. If you sell today, means whatever goods you have in a future time, your goods value will be increased and you will sell at higher price to the other clients. This is the repo diagram. Means first is dealer, counterparty, and settlement date. Means counterparty borrow money from the dealer, then they have to lend the security. Again, the end of the term means they have pay back money plus interest at repo. Means they return your money with the interest rate at repo. Again, the take back securities. So this is the process of repo diagram. And there's one person, there's second party. First, that person will give money to this. Again, this person lend the securities. Again, they will pay back money. They will that person will give money to the interest, and again they pay back the securities. So this is the repo diagram. In this way, both parties will go. So now there's a difference between the money market and capital market. First, meaning it refers the whole network of organization, institutions, instruments, deal medium and long term funds. Basically, capital market deal with the long term funds and money market deal with the short term funds, and the maturity period is up to 1 year. Liquidity, basically only active trading securities. Which already have on the market. There is a formal arrangement of creating liquidity. In the money market, we have to create a liquidity in the organization. Safety. In this market, securities of every company are bought and sold, and there is more risk involved. Capital market, there is more risk because every kind of company bought and sold the securities with the help of broker, and they find a client. So there is more risk involved. But in the money market, the transactions are made in the instruments issued by the financial institutions and financial strong companies. Meaning basically, in the money market, the financial institution will take the money from the financial institution. Each and transaction will be recorded. And in this way, there are some companies which are financially strong if they borrow money to their clients, to their customers. Next, expected return. The expected return are high as the scope of earning capital gains, and long-term prospect is also shared by the company in the form of high dividends and bonuses. Means in the capital market, we can generate the numerous benefits. We can increase our capital. We can also have a long-term, we can generate a profit. And those people who investment in terms of shares, they can also get dividend and bonus. Shared by the company in form of high dividend and bonuses. These kind of issues may be arises in the capital market. Because if the companies gain profit, they do not give dividend to their clients. So these kind of issues may be arising in the capital market. But in the money market, the expected return is less due to short duration and low risk. Due to short time period, So maybe the return is less and there is low risk. But in that, the capital return is high. The duration, the maturity is more than 1 year. It's sitting from 1 day to day and 1 year. Investment outlay does not necessarily require huge investment outlay. The unit price is low, rupees 10, rupees 100. So even trading for lots are small. So it depends upon how much the amount is not fixed. So it depends upon how much you invest in the capital market. In what way? It depends upon you. Money market transaction take huge sum of money as instruments are quite expensive. But in the case of money market, we need to use amount of money, so which are quite expensive because instruments are quite expensive. Participant, individual investor as well as institutional investors like financial institutions, banks, corporate, foreign investor, participant in the capital market transaction. In these are kind of all people and all organizations will become a participant of capital market. But in the participant of RBI, the participant of money brackets, RBI, commercial bank, financial institution, mutual funds, corporate house, individual investors do not participate in money market. Individual investors do not. But in the case of capital market, individual investors can participate. But in the case of money market, individual investors cannot invest in the money market. May last for instrument traded. Instruments of capital market include equity shares, preference shares, bonds, and debentures. These are the instruments of capital market. And some of the main instruments used in money market are commercial paper, trade bills, trade bills, certificate of deposit. The instruments are different of capital market as well as money market. Thank you.